All right, so listen, Lil Boat decided to drop his debut album, his debut project, and God. All right, so listen, I'm already not here for it, all right? 21 tracks, it's about as long as The Lion King. I doubt it'll be as good. Make you want to commit suicide. What happened? Oh, man, I don't know. What was that? Lil Yachty being known for being Lil Yachty. Dropped his tape or his album today, Teenage Emotion, and we're going to listen to it. Without bias, hopefully enjoy it. I wanna die. Huh? What the? Without further ado, Bluetooth on, connect this, plug this, eat this. We are ready to listen to our first Lil Yachty project on this channel. Kill me. Oh wow, that's crazy, man. I just keep hearing these voices. Like, I don't know what's going on. Track number one, Like a Star. God help me.
Where do I start? Dad, who has been supporting my nephews. They both have lots to say.
Yachty, what is this voice? This is disgusting.
Sip a beer. Still fuck holes by the pier.
He's got a hands down on production.
And I done did it all before. I done had sex with six different whores at the same
time. Come on, Yachty, really? Don't make me pause you in the very... In your intro track, don't make me do it, okay? You're doing good, all right? I like the sound. I like where you're headed. I like your voice, now that you're not trying to do that, girl, let me talk to you, kind of voice that you were doing in the very beginning of the track. But, the bars. You didn't need to put that in there. I know for a fact you just used that because you couldn't find another word. Stop it.
And my mom walk around with a frozen wrist.
It's like a hip-hop lullaby. Like, what? I'm not saying that it's bad, it's just awkward, you know, when you hear somebody in his position that has such a large influence over such a substantial fan base, to hear somebody kind of make music like this is like... Next track, DN Freestyle.
All day I'm rocked up, plotting on a bad bitch to come and suck dick. Cook, French toast, and clean the bathroom. Every night you pussy,
okay.
Niggas turn you us. Yeah, you see how you smash on him. Niggas say he wanted to
fight.
He was stuck between trying to find friends who want innovation, but I still kill. Fear and I'm getting fat, fuck, it's time to practice. My side bitch from Sacramento didn't be giving free clout to the unworked. But if Licky make sure it's still working, goddamn.
Oh my God. Told her I couldn't get hard, make it, lick it, Yachty. You wrote that down? I'm not trying to discredit him for the good in this track because I think the beat is banging. There is so much bass, heavy production, but the flow does not change the entire song. The only thing that ruins this track for me is Yachty himself, because he lacks the versatility to carry a beat like this for me. Can't rap on a beat like this and not have bars. And where they at, man? Where they at? No T.I., where they at?
My bitch ride with me like the body truck, you nigga, run up, get done.
Okay, that's... I can't be mad at that. My bitch ride with me like the bride of Chucky. I mean, it makes me want to die still, but it's not bad. Next track, Peekaboo, featuring Migos. I've actually heard this track already. We're just going to skim through it.
Had a dope stashed in the cabinet. Mama couldn't tell me shit. What was my daddy? Look at my pedic. I'm flexing on pedic.
If Offset's not your favorite member of the Migos, you're doing something wrong in life. You just are. I don't want to hear you. Track number four, Dirty Mouth.
Bro, I know these niggas are not really doing what they're doing.
I like this beat, though.
Mommy crew came with amenities. You gotta pay for my energy.
Okay.
Pop out the trunk. Don't make me two-handed pump.
Yachty. Yachty! You're not about that. Stop. What's wrong? Who tried to press you and made you feel like you gotta act tough on these tracks? You don't have to do that.
Send me pictures of a coochie. Said that nickname the Gypsy. I get more pussy than Preston. My nigga.
That beat!
My next bitch look like a top model. She's like a baby bottle.
I'm not telling you like this, man.
God. Yachty! I bite like a T-Rex? She sucked dick like a baby bottle. M's,
and I'm talking about the letter before N, nigga. M's, bitch.
Pussy pictures like Kirby. Yeah. My bitch suck it up just like Kirby. Yeah. She drop wins like it's Kentucky Derby. Yeah. She suck with pussy. Why? I had to show my body. Yeah.
I like the added vocals in the background to reassure you that Yachty, really believes what he's saying right now. The Kirby line almost had me about to cringe, but he cleaned it up by saying that it's pink like Kirby, but then he cleans it up by saying she suck it up I like Kirby. Another banging beat, and I like Yachty's flow on this one. I think he definitely took control over the beat, had a nice flow. But again, a lot of it is just like, fam, what you doing? And I like on this track how Yachty actually says to everybody that he doesn't care if you respect him. He never cared about respect. He only cared about making money. So, at least we know where he stands. Track number 5, Harley.
My diamonds go bling, bling, bling. Lobo.
Listen, that track wasn't... Oh, man. Find something nice to say. So, listen, that track wasn't the worst thing I've ever heard, but I've noticed the past few tracks I've listened to, I hear a severe lack of rapping from Yachty. Like, he tends to just say things and have a flow on it. It doesn't necessarily go or, you know, fit when it comes to making a rhyme scheme or a pattern or having bars on this thing so far. It just seems that he's talking and then putting a flow on his words and making it seem like he's rapping. But the Harley bike thing, or maybe it would have went over better if he, you know, was speaking to me and using bike metaphors throughout the entire song. That probably would have made me like the song a lot more and get over the fact that this sounds like a 14-year-old who put auto-tune over his voice and he's going on his first bike ride with his dad. His dad is the football coach that's disappointed in him. Track number 6, All Around Me, featuring YG. Hold up. YG, how much did he pay you for this feature? I like it.
Let no girl on the beat, so what the fuck? I keep bad bitches all around me. Zip my homies in all the ways we straight. I'm in Houston with a bitch and her friend shorty. I'm so fucked up, I don't give a damn. And if you owe me, I need taxes like I'm Uncle Sam.
Oh, Kamaya, he works well on this. Never mind, I'm gonna take it back.
I told Lil Bro, get your money and fuck these eyes. Don't worry about these niggas, your shit popping, they ain't popping. Yeah, they on my bed, no. Put my niggas on, that's what I'm supposed to do.
It's not hitting yet, it's not there yet, bud. YG actually contradicts the point of this song. The point of the song is for Yachty to be like, I got hoes and I got my dudes with me. And then YG comes on and says, hey, don't worry about that. So what's going on? I think YG's sound is compromised a little bit on this track. I'm not saying that it's bad. It's just for YG to be on this track. Why? I doubt Lil Yachty fans will appreciate the YG feature anyway, so I'm wondering kind of why it's there. Track number 7, Say My Name. Please do not be what I think it is.
My name, say my name, say my name. In the credibility by my side and my wrist, I'm bling blow. Got pictures in the magazine, get in the crowd. I want you to say my name out. All these bitches,
oh my god.
Name, say my name now.
What is Yachty's real name anyway? These tracks, I'm not gonna sleep on them for production. They are bangers. These tracks are some of the greatest sounding songs that I've heard in a minute, but what are you doing, fam? Whose man's is this right now? Track number 8, All You Had to Say, was Yachty's name in the previous track. I see what you did. You're not low. People switching up like the late shift. Oh, God. Yachty, please tell me this is a freestyle and you didn't really write that down. Beautifully produced, but it's the same song on a different track. Oh my god, my voice is so loud. Okay, Yachty.
That's all you had to
say. So as I was saying before, I was rudely interrupted by the beautiful transition in that beat. It's so far the same scenario over a different track. These past 8 tracks, it's been the same song pretty much. Track number 9, Better, featuring Stefflin Don. Alright. Are we in Jamaica?
It always could always be better. You miss all the more. Everything in life better.
I like this track, okay?
I'll express my love in the letter.
I love this right now. I like this song though. So I'm assuming Yachty is speaking to possible people who are dealing with suicide with that track, or maybe people who are in depression. I really do enjoy that track for the message. It's very uplifting. The sound of it brings you to this tranquil place. Maybe a beach is what I picture. And you're there, you're having a great time. Things can always be better. But he's also explaining to you in this track that life isn't always going to be like this. I like the message of the track. It sounds great. His voice over this song actually works a lot. And track number 10, Forever Young, featuring Diplo.
First the lights, the stars burning nice for me. And y'all was afraid if I made the wrong move. If I break your heart, then I'm gonna lose it.
Okay, Yachty. Pick it up, I like this. Like I said, these tracks for just the sheer amount of just great production that they have. Production wise, this thing is done beautifully. Track number 11, Lady in Yellow. Is this his attempt at an R&B track? Bro, Bryson just dropped. I don't want to hear it.
Would you like to push pedals through the meadow?
Oh my god, no.
Will you play more games than a fellow?
Play more games than a fellow? Do you want me to turn this album off, Yachty? You play more games than a fellow? Come kick it with a fellow? You wrote that down, boy.
It's like a queen, just let me in between. Let me love on you.
Let me love on you.
Yellow skin, yellow hair, getting out of yellow taxi, baby, where you going?
First of all, Yachty, hold up. I got a problem with what you just said. What in this album is supposed to be about, like, relating to all? But why would you make emphasis on the color of her skin? Boy, I'm not feeling it. This track is just a horrible attempt at trying to be, I guess, romantic to some degree. Yachty doesn't explore different flows. He doesn't get into a romantic side of himself. It doesn't have any, like, swagger to it. It's just, hey, I see a girl I like, let me go talk to her. And if you make love to this song, there's something wrong with you. Track number 12, Moments in Time.
Do you feel good?
Yeah, I feel great. Thanks for asking.
Moments from my index finger through your thighs. All in my life.
Oh god!
I thought you was such a scare. Gripping on your hips while you hold the chair. It's my job to make your knees weak.
Not doing your job right, you're fired. I just can't get into it. His voice is just, it's no. I have never had more of a horrible listening experience than right now. Two R&B tracks back to back that I can't get into because Yachty does not have the vocal performance to give me that mood. The tracks themselves are great, but when Yachty hops on it, it's like it just takes me out of the mood instantly. Fantano, if you review this album, I dare you to I dare you to justify this track. I dare you. You gave him a 7, and you gave Blankface a 5. There, I said it. I got it off my chest. I don't like doing that, okay? I don't like referencing other albums. I gave Drake's More Life an 8, and I remember giving Logic's album a 7. Yeah, that's probably not right either, but I still did it. But this is not justifiable. Stop it. Track number 13. Other shit, interlude. Alright, I feel you.
I'm on some other shit. 30 plays, fuck that other shit. And that's not the luck though for the darkest.
Yeah, I don't even. Track number 14, X-Men featuring Evander Grimm. You can't get away with that. Break her back like a tree, like a twig, like what? Like a break.
Allow my name to get relevant. Think it look funny? You going down like gummy cut?
Dripping on lit. Fuck, she wet. X-Men. Psychos, Philly's young.
You get it? I really fall like pillow talking. I know when she kisses you. Yes, I'm a dog with a Gucci collar. I get that brother. I saw what you drive as a car, bro. You shouldn't want beef from the start. Everywhere I probably.
I'm sure what I saw what you drive as a car, bro. What else do you drive? A vehicle? What do you mean? Track number 15, Bring It Back. I don't know if I can do this. For those of you wondering, this is straight vodka in this cup. It's not water. I'm trying to get messed up so bad right now, and it's not working. It sounds like The Weeknd's track, I Feel It Coming. It sounds a lot like that, actually. Bring it back to him. Whoever Lil Yachty's talking about, can you please go back to him so we don't have to hear a track like this again? Thanks. Track number 16, Running With A Ghost, featuring Grace. Okay, I like this. Beautiful.
You used to kill the whole company. I used to put even when you glare.
Oh, yeah.
You say you feel it in your chest. I'll stay the night, keep you company. Oh, I cannot last with the money team.
Alright, so for this track, I feel like it was a nice attempt from Grace to hop on something like this. I just feel like she's so misplaced with the subject matter for Lil Yachty. He's talking about something that I guess in a way goes against her vocals. Her vocals give you this angelic kind of presence, like you're about to be moved off to another world, and then Yachty literally grabs you by the foot and brings you back down to earth. Beautifully produced. Content of the song just not there. Track number 17, FYI, Now Know.
Fall, nigga, I thought you know. Baby, 10 chains, real gold, a lock of 40, baby. Way back with fall, nigga, I thought you know. So all the birds know what's up. When they put it on the boat, wasn't organ how the ducks on me. Get them coats with her. She
like
keep
this.
That coat with her. I saw her coat, she got a coke figure. Not a good boat, boy, I don't wear a hell figure, no.
Right, a lot of heavy bass. It took me a little bit to get into it, but a lot of, what is this? A lot of heavy bass, thanks, Tappy. I posted on Twitter that I wasn't feeling this album so far, and people seem to be agreeing with me. The thing about this thing is just, God, I will come back to that track just for, you know, the beat, the heavy production. He mentions his deals, Nautica, and now he's going with Hilfiger, but that's cool, man. I think that's dope. But the mom thing is just like, we still making mom references in 2017. Track number 18, Priorities.
My priorities, I fuck my priorities. 30 callers, a call for a jiggable. I ain't got college school, they some haters. The whole squalor hustles like the movie takers. Got a bougie, I can't do no
joke. Oh my God, dude, why? Like the movie takers, what? Why do you do this to me?
Whatever I want to when I say so. Rolling, rolling, rolling like a roller coaster. Let's try to get away from the Lil Yachty. And she sucked me like an insect. She my stepsister, so I guess that's aneurysm.
Wait. I know he's not about to say what I just thought he said. First of all, the line about she sucked me like an insect. Boy. What? Why? You're writing these down.
She my stepsister, so I guess that's incest. I could not.
Incest. She's my stepsister, so that's incest. Oh my God, yo. Why do you... What? My head is sweating. Why are you doing this? Don't put that, don't do that, man, don't, why'd you do that? Track number 19, No More. Yet No More, please. That's what you've been doing the whole, what did I listen to the album for if this is, this track is about his Lil Yachty not being able to take all the things that he's been doing throughout the entire album. I don't know if this is his point in the album where he's maturing, but almost 20 tracks in is a pretty late start. Track number 20, Made of Glass.
Yeah, but you don't even see me. Am I made up of glass? What we once talked. Am I made up of glass?
I like this. I like the production. I love it.
On the internet, talking about us both, they're just vultures. I want your panties wet.
What is your obsession with trying to make girls wet, okay? If it's not wet, don't try to force it. She's not into you. And I wouldn't say that I hated that track. It was just, Yachty, as far as subject matter, doesn't have enough depth to him as an artist for me to connect with it, especially when you consider the beautiful production that it holds. It's like, this is awesome, amazing production, and then you're kind of messing it up because you don't have enough substance as an artist to get me to connect to it. But it's beautifully produced, and I think there is some actual good instrumentation in there. Maybe it's electronic, like computerized, it's not live, but it does sound very nice. Track number 21, Mama, featuring Sonya or Sonya Elise, outro.
Are you giving me, I can't repay, queen of my world, my mama.
Of my life, my mama. I make sure that you get love.
It's very endearing, I like it.
She used to work hard for us.
Halfway expected his mom to be singing the vocals on that track. I really enjoyed that. Paying homage to your mom. It's kind of funny that after all this time of spending with other women and other girls, you get to the point where you notice who is the most important or the most special woman that will ever be in your life, your mother. So salute to you, Lil Yachty. This isn't gonna be a long review. This thing is okay. Whoa, I was about to say something I'm gonna regret. Calm down. The cover art is a lie. Yachty has all these people on this album cover as if they are going to be able to relate to every track. I get that he's trying to say within this album that multiple people from multiple groups could connect to it, but I don't see that being the case when you tease these other groups on your album cover. You got drug dealers, you got gay people, you got I think this is a girl with a skin discoloration disease, I guess some people dealing with obesity. I just don't see how this ties into all of those aspects in all those walks of life. Mainly this album talks about and discusses a girl that Yachty just can't seem to get over, even though he's almost at the point where he's no longer in his teens. He's still talking about the things that impacted him the most, I assume, in his teenage years. And to me, if this album is going to be called Teenage Emotions, I don't feel it having that much depth when you only talk about the females or the female that gave you that emotion. Maybe this girl invoked that emotion within you, and that's fine, but could you add more substance to it other than just saying I get her wet? If you love this album, I think you'll love it for production, and I would not be mad at anybody if they told me they really enjoyed this album from a production standpoint and that they didn't need to, they could kind of tune out Lil Yachty and his lyrics. I can understand that because this thing is beautifully produced. It's got a lot of heavy bass. I love the way it sounds, but Lil Yachty himself, he just misses the mark for me. His subject matter isn't there. When he is talking about something other than talking about making a girl wet, he's giving me cringy bars. He's giving me bars that I'm like, you really wrote that down? You really decided to put this on a track? Or he's taking me out of the feeling that the instrumental of the song originally gave me, like on the two R&B tracks he had on here, or I guess there are multiple R&B tracks or whatever you may say, tracks that are supposed to deliver a romantic vibe to you, but he takes you immediately out of the element, at least in my opinion. This thing is full of tracks that kind of cover the same subject matter, but there are 21 of them almost. And for me, I just don't think it's needed. This thing really could have been shortened down to 12 or 13 tracks. 21 is almost a film. You're almost watching a movie at this point, and it feels like a job halfway through. About around track 10, I'm ready for the album to be over, but it keeps going. And at some point you're thinking maybe he's saving the best tracks for the most motivational or inspirational, or the tracks that are going to connect people the most towards the end, but that's not the case. It's just more of the same dribbling nonsense that we got earlier in the beginning. And there are a couple tracks on here where Yachty tries to give a hip-hop rap vibe, but he still misses the marks because his bars are so weak. I cannot get with this album as far as respecting Yachty as a rapper or listening to him as a hip-hop artist. I don't think you're gonna find enjoyment out of this album. Even listening to it from a R&B or a pop influence standpoint, you're still not gonna enjoy this album as much because I don't think it's executed well. Lil Yachty, Teenage Emotion, for me, I'll throw a 2 out of 10 on this thing. This was barely listenable. I like the track about his mom. I like the track that features Grace, even though Yachty kind of pulls me away from that. There are just some bars on here that are not forgivable, like the incest line. I break her back like a tree branch or a tree stem or whatever he said. There's just some stuff on here you just can't get away with. And Yachty, there's too much on this album that I feel like was just not thought out. And I don't expect lyrics from Lil Yachty, but that doesn't mean because I don't expect him to be hardcore lyricism that he gets to get away with the worst bars. I don't know. I like the album from a production standpoint. Didn't like it from a substance standpoint. Didn't like it lyrically. Didn't like it for subject matter. He doesn't hold enough weight for me as an artist to be impactful, to even be making an album that kind of encompasses all of these teenage emotions that don't really encompass other groups of people like it teases on the album cover. So for me, it just misses the mark severely. If you like the album, that's great. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you keep listening to it. Just respect that this is my opinion. I'm not messing with it. Yachty, 2 out of 10. Hope you guys had a great day. Bryson Tiller just dropped him. Go listen to that album because that's gotta make me feel better. There's not enough vodka in my cup right now.